On the occasion of Wildlife Week, on behalf of Tadoba family, I welcome you all to this virtual journey through the forest of Tadoba Andhari Tiger Reserve. As we speak, the world is going through a terrible pandemic and everyone has been forced to retreat into their homes for months together. This has perhaps forced us to think about nature more deeply and reimagine our relationship with nature as an individual and also as a species. To reduce the pain of being confined in homes and away from natural environment, we at TATR have tried to enliven the spirits of wildlife lovers around the country and across the globe through a small series of virtual safaris. We are thankful to the organizers of the Wildlife Week at Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, for including this latest episode as a part of Wildlife Week celebrations. Tadoba Tiger Reserve is a home to hundreds of species of plants and animals, including the majestic tigers. It is an example of typical southern tropical dry deciduous ecosystem in our central Indian landscape, which is dominated by teak and bamboo. Over the years, with sustained conservation efforts, it has emerged as an important source area for the tigers in central India, with its good connectivity with other tiger reserves and also with surrounding forest outside Tiger Reserve. Apart from tiger, it has a wonderful mix of diversity of flora and fauna, which is represented by over 600 species of plants, 80 species of mammals belonging to different orders, over 280 recorded species of birds, over 60 species of reptiles and amphibians, and 28 species of snakes. It is a matter of concern, though, that several of these species are in the Red Data Book of IUCN as vulnerable and endangered. Besides being home to these wonderful species of plants and animals, Tadoba Tiger Reserve also acts as a catchment of two important rivers of the area, namely Irai and Andhari, which are important source of water for the industry and agriculture. This fact actually underlines the economic value of this tiger reserve in simplest of terms. Let's now ride into the forests of Tadoba and enjoy the richness of life, its sounds and scenes through the eyes of our field team. I'm sure the real-time scenes of the forest as they open up in front of you will raise your spirits and strengthen your bond with nature. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. From the lush green thickets of teak forest of Tadoba, we heard the alarm calls of spotted deers, and we decided to wait for a while to check our luck if we could see any big cat. These frequent calls of spotted deers alarm the adjoining groups of ungulates around. Here we can see that the spotted deers are vigilant and alert. As if they sense any danger around, they will make alarm calls to alert the other members of the group. Oh yes, there. If you see carefully, you'll see a tiger passing from the bushes. The jungles will always surprise you with its unfold stories. This area, just before the Midsummers, was ruled by the undisputed king, the T-54. But during this lockdown, a lot new has happened. We have a new male here, T-100. Tiger symbolizes the wilderness and the well-being of ecosystem. The combination of grace, strength, agility, and enormous power has earned the tiger its pride of place as the national animal of India. Let's move towards the pristine grassland ecosystem of Taduba. Back in 2012, this was a village and relocated and has emerged as a beautiful grassland. These beautiful grasses provide a good forage for the ungulates like spotted deers and blue bulls. Nilgai is the largest Asian antelope in Taduba. It shares its habitat with four-horned antelopes, cheetahs, and the Indian gaur. These long grasses provide a perfect hideout for tigers as well. Grassland ecosystem also plays a very important role in harboring granivorous insectivorous birds. Just like the grey jungle fowl. Indian roller. Green bee eater. And the black-winged kite. This raptor is best known for its habitat of hovering over open grasslands. And its prey includes grasshoppers, crickets, and other large insects, lizards, and rodents. The graceful Indian peafowl is native to South Asia. The male's resplendent coloring has earned it the title of India's national bird. These dark clouds and lightning will bring a downpour to Taduba. A normal monsoon in Taduba has an annual rainfall of 1175 mm. TATR is drained by two rivers, the Andhari, which originates in Pandarponi, and Irai River, which flows in the western half. Both the rivers has base flow, which indicates that they are recharged from groundwater. It not only provides water for the wildlife, but is also home to marsh crocodiles. The dry forest turns into a lush green carpet covered with a thin blanket of fog and mist. These filled water bodies attract a lot of water birds. Just like here, we can see herons and cormorants perched on near water. Both are resident birds of Taduba. This is one more bird common in quite aquatic habitats, is the Indian pond heron. These are freshwater crocodiles and love to eat fishes. Look at that broad snout and perfectly jagged teeth. The crocodiles have a V-shaped snout, whereas the alligators have a U-shaped snout. Taduba is known to be home for another big cat, the Indian leopard, listed as vulnerable under the IUCN Red List. This beautiful rosettes of Indian leopard are larger than the other subspecies. And yes, unlike tigers, they are also solitary, and every individual has unique rosette pattern. The Sambar deers, one of the favorite prey species of the tiger, which can feed it for up to 4 days. Another endangered species, the top predators, the Indian dholes, coexists together with tigers and leopards. Hanuman langurs are diurnal and semi-arboreal, spending 80% of their time on the ground using quadrupedal locomotion. They use trees primarily for sleeping. Hanuman langurs, interestingly, have about 19 different types of calls, and also based on the TATR Phase 4 monitoring 2019, the average group size of langurs in Taduba is from 2 to 22. It is very rightly said that India is one of the biggest wildlife treasures in the world, which has a wide array of ecosystems like the tropical rainforests, deciduous monsoons forest, freshwater marshes, lagoons, freshwater lakes, rivers, mangroves, desert, marines, which is a house for thousands and thousands of species. The unique and varied ecosystems found in India supports quite a number of wildlife that are found nowhere else in the world. I hope and I'm sure with this small bit in the fight for conservation of India's wildlife will be really helpful. As it is very rightly said, never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. In fact, it's the only thing that ever has. Said by Margaret Mead. Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed this virtual safari of Taduba Andhari Tiger Reserve.